Hello, Word of Faith Online Church. On behalf of our Bishop, Dr. Dale C. Bronner, and our First Lady, Dr. Nina Bronner, we welcome you to our week of online prayer and intercession. The Bible tells us in Jeremiah 33:3, call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things that thou knowest. As we seek God in prayer, we're going to be calling unto him. Our theme for these next 5 days of intercessory prayer is seeking the face of God. It comes from the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, verse 14. The King James Version reads, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I would hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sin, and I will heal their land. Church, as we know it today, the land needs healing. The land of our minds, of our hearts, the lands of our country, of our nation, the land of our world needs healing. And so we thank you for joining with us to seek the face of God. The word face in the Hebrew translation is presence. So as we say we're seeking the face of God, we are seeking the presence of God. We understand that in the presence of the Lord is the fullness of joy. And in his presence are pleasures forevermore. Also in the presence of the Lord, it's by the Holy Spirit that we will be able to receive divine instruction and guidance for our lives. Day one of our intercessory prayer will focus on returning to God with repentance and forgiveness. Day two, we're going to be interceding on behalf of children, the elderly, and our families. And on day three, we're going to be praying for revival and restoration. On day three, it's going to be very unique in that the first 15 minutes of prayer will be in English, and the second half of the 15 minutes will be in Spanish. And then on day four, we're going to pray for peace and kindly attitudes. We'll culminate our prayer and intercession 5-day period on the last day, praying for love and unity. Although our prayers today and you joining us won't have a lot of visual effect, we want you to hear what the Spirit is saying through the audible effect. We'll actually have two people praying each day, two intercessors for a 30-minute period. Also, online, we do have our hosts available. They're going to be sharing with you topics and our scriptures for the day, as well as information on how you can contact us to share your praise reports and testimonies. Well, let's get ready to go before the throne of the Lord. Would you open your Bible with me to Psalms chapter 119, 147. Psalms 119, 147. And as you have that scripture, just drop in the chat, I'm ready to pray. Glory be to God. I'm going to be reading from the New Living Translation, and we'll use this scripture each day as we open up our prayer. And it reads, I rise early before the sun is up. I cry out for help. And I put my hope in your words. Today, our first day, as we pray and intercede, our focus is returning to God. Returning to God. Hallelujah. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day of prayer and this day of intercession. We ask, Father God, that your Spirit would rest upon us. We pray, Father God, that as we come together as a people, we humble ourselves, Father God, to pray, to seek your face, and to turn from our ways. Lord, in the presence of you is the fullness of joy. So we seek your presence, Father God. We seek, dear Heavenly Father, your face. We come as a nation, Father God, confessing, Lord, that we've sinned and come short of your glory. But Father, in the name of Jesus, we come as a family, Father God, repenting of our sins. We come, Father God, understanding that all those that call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This day, dear Heavenly Father, a clean heart and renew the right spirit within us, Father God. Take not your Holy Spirit from us, Lord. We've sinned and we've fallen short of your glory. But you said, dear Heavenly Father, if we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Lord, we come, dear Heavenly Father, casting, Father God, our cares upon you, knowing that you care for us. Thank you, dear Heavenly Father, for the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. We bless you and we praise you. From the rising of the sun, Lord, to the going down of the same, your name alone is worthy to be praised. Lord, look upon us, Father God, this day. As we come to the throne of grace, we come boldly that we may obtain help and find mercy in a time of need. Father God, the nation needs you. Your people need you, Father God. And we cry out, Abba, Father, have mercy, Father God, upon us. Lord, let your hand, Father God, rest upon us. As we press in, Father God, for prayer and intercession, we repent, Father God. We ask for forgiveness of our sins. We ask, dear Heavenly Father, for the blood of Jesus Christ to wash us and to cleanse us. Dear Heavenly Father, for the things that we've said, the things that we've looked upon, or the things that we've did, I thank you, Father God, that you'll be with us. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Father God, thank you that as we come this morning, Lord, you sit high and you look low. Heaven is your throne and earth is your footstool. We thank you, dear Heavenly Father, that as we cry unto you, you hear, because you said, Father God, in your word, your arm is not short that it cannot save, neither your ear heavy that it cannot hear. So this day, Father God, we come and we repent. We bow down, Father God, and ask for forgiveness, Father God, for where we've fallen short. And dear Heavenly Father, you said in your word, and when we stand praying, forgive, that your Heavenly Father would also forgive us. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Father God, for this time of intercession. You said, how can two walk together except they be agreed? Father God, we agree with everyone that's online that your will and your way is accomplished on the earth. Father God, we forgive from the past hurts. We forgive, dear Heavenly Father, for those that have wronged us. We forgive, dear Heavenly Father, for those, Father God, that have mistreated us, Father God. We forgive them. We forgive those actions, those words, Father God. And Lord, we thank you that as we forgive, you also forgive us. It's a time for us to return to you, God, to seek you with all our heart. We lay aside the sin and the weight which would so easily beset us. And we run this race, Father God, with patience, looking unto you, the author and the finisher of our faith. Father God, there may be some hearts that are heavy, Father God, today as we enter into intercession. Family members have lost loved ones, dear Heavenly Father. There's been trials and changes, Father God, throughout the world that all of us, dear Heavenly Father, are working through. But Lord, you said that we can look to the hills from which cometh our help, and that our help, it comes from the Lord. Father, we thank you that our help comes from you, and no other help do we know. We bless you, Father God, this day. That's the fruit of our lips, giving thanks unto you. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good and his mercy endures forever. Oh, give thanks unto the God of gods. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord. We give thanks and praise and honor and glory unto you, Father God, for the great things that you're doing. We thank you, Father God, for moving throughout the breadth of the land. We thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit sealing us until the day of redemption. We thank you, dear Heavenly Father, that you commanded your love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Oh, Lord, wash us. Wash us with the precious blood, dear Heavenly Father. Create within us a clean heart. Renew the right spirit within us. Cast us not away from thy presence, neither take thy Holy Spirit from us. Lord, we repent and we ask, Father God, that this day the blood of Jesus Christ would cleanse us from all sin, all unrighteousness, Father God, Dear Heavenly Father, where we've wronged others, forgive us, dear Heavenly Father. Lord, the sins of omission and the sins of commission that we've created, Father God, and done against you, we ask you to forgive us, Father God. Please, Lord, let your blood cover us. So that way, as we come boldly to the throne of grace, you don't see us, Father God, because no flesh will glory in your presence, but you will see the Spirit of the living God. Dear Heavenly Father, we pray that we return to our first love. The first love when we were excited and got saved, Father God, and spent time in your word, Father, time in prayer, and spent time in praise and worship. Through the years, Father God, some of us have gotten busy with our careers, with our jobs, with our businesses, with our lives, with our family, even being caregivers, Father God, for our elderly parents and family members. We've gotten busy, Father God, but we're asking, Father God, today that we would return unto our first love, just as you pointed out in Revelation 2 to the church of Ephesus. We return, Father God, with humble hearts. We return, dear Heavenly Father, with gratefulness. We return, dear Heavenly Father, with goodness. We thank you, Father God, for the precious blood of Christ covering us from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet. And Lord, as we stand, Father God, in the gap for the nations, we pray for the nations. We intercede on behalf of the nations. Father God, we pray, Father God, for the Haitians in Haiti. Father God, humanitarian efforts to be able to reach those people in the name of Jesus. We pray, Father God, that there would be provisions, Father God, of food, water, clothing, and shelter for them. You see the times, Father God. You neither sleep nor slumber that keeps Israel, Father God. Your eye is on the righteous and your ear is open unto our prayer. Father, we stand in the gap for the people, Father God, in Haiti right now. And we thank you, dear Heavenly Father, for the efforts being made to save. We thank you, Father God, for the efforts to heal. We thank you, Father God, for the efforts to surround the people in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, touch the children there. Touch, dear Heavenly Father. You said, suffer the children to come unto me and forbid them not. We pray for those children, Father God. We pray for those men and for those women, dear Heavenly Father. And we pray right now in the name of Jesus, Father God, shine forth. We take authority, Father God, over the works of darkness, Father God, in Haiti, in the name of Jesus. You said in your word, Lord, whatsoever we bind on earth, you'll bind in heaven. And whatever we loose on earth, you'll loose in heaven. We take authority, Father God, over witchcraft, Father God, over the occult. We bind the works of darkness, Father God, against Haiti right now in the name of Jesus. We cast them out to outer darkness, where they seek peace and rest and they find none. But Father God, we loose the blood of Jesus. We loose the power of the Holy Ghost. We loose the truth of your word, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father God, for being there right now, Father God, and let your glory, Father God, fill that place. Lord, Father God, we pray for those in Afghanistan right now. We pray, Father God, for the unrest, Father God, at the airport in Kabul. We ask, Heavenly Father, that your arm, Father God, would stretch forth, Father God, and cause, Father God, there to be peace, Father God, and order in the name of Jesus. As people, Father God, are trying to get to the airport and being airlifted out, Father God, we ask for order, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We pray that, Father God, you would keep those troops, Father God, that were flown back, dear Heavenly Father, to assist. We pray that you would surround them, Father God, with protection. Surround them, Father God, with love. Surround them, Father God, with your glory in the mighty name of Jesus. A standard, Father God, because those are someone's father, mother, sister, brother, aunt, uncle. We pray, Father God, that your loving kindness and tender mercies would surround them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father God, we lift up Jerusalem, Father God. You said we're to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. We pray right now, Father, for Jerusalem. We pray, Father God, for the peace of Jerusalem. We pray for the prosperity of Jerusalem. We pray, dear Heavenly Father, that you would lift up a standard and you would be seen and known, Father God, even throughout the Gaza Strip. Lord, in the name of Jesus, you said if your people which are called by your name, would humble themselves and pray and seek your face and turn from their wicked ways. Then you would hear from heaven. Father God, you would forgive our sins and heal our land. We come, Father God, in the blessed name of Jesus and thank you for lifting up a standard for your people in Jerusalem. And Lord, we bless you, Father God. We praise you and we magnify your name. We thank you, Father God, for the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. And Father God, as we call out, as we repent, as we praise, as we ask for forgiveness, we thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayer. We thank you, Father God, for moving upon the hearts of everybody, Father God, within the online church. We pray, Father God, that you would keep them and keep their families, Father God. We pray, Father God, for those parents, dear Heavenly Father, that are trying to find a way for their children, Father God. We pray, Father God, for physical, spiritual, financial means, dear Heavenly Father, to be met. We thank you, Father God, that your hand is keeping watch over the children, Father God, as some of them go back to school. Father God, we ask that the angel of the Lord that encamps around about them that fear you would be with our children, Father God, on the bus stops. Be with our children, Father God, that are going off to college. Be with our children, Father God, as they're driving. We thank you, Father God, that safety is of the Lord. We thank you, Father God, for your stretched out hand being resting upon our children, guiding them and leading them. You said in your word, Father God, that great shall be the peace of our children, and they shall be taught of the Lord. We thank you that the Spirit of the Lord rests upon our children, the spirit of wisdom, of counsel, of might, of quick understanding, and fear of the Lord. We thank you, Father God, that you're surrounding our children with songs of deliverance. We thank you that you're giving them a mind to serve you and in spirit and in truth. And we come against, Father God, the ways of the world, the tactics of the world. We bind, Father God, the lust of the eye, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. And Father God, we lose holiness and righteousness for our children. Father God, touch them in the name of Jesus. Let them taste and see. Let them taste and see. Let them taste and see that the Lord is good in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, for a goodly heritage, Father God, for our children. We thank you, Father God, that we come against, Father God, spiritual blindness that would try to blind their minds, Father God. We take authority over spiritual blindness, Father God, right now in the name of Jesus. We bind, Father God, the spirit of rebellion. We come against, dear Heavenly Father, the spirit of alcoholism, drugs, substance abuse, Father God, pornography. We take authority over those works of darkness and we say, no, they will have no work in our children. But Lord, we loose the blood of Jesus Christ and we loose the power of the Holy Spirit over our children. You're stirring them up right now in the name of Jesus. Those children, Father God, that left home angry. You said in your word, Father God, that the heart of the king is in your hand and you turn the heart whithersoever you will, just as the rivers of water. We thank you, Father God, for taking that stony heart and making it flesh where those children will repent. They'll come back to their parents and say that they're sorry. Father, in the name of Jesus, you said in your word that children should honor their father and mother, that their days would be long. We honor, we respect, Father God, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Father God, for bringing our sons and our daughters from afar. Oh, we bless you, Father God. We praise you, Father God. We thank you. Lord, you said in your word, where two or three are gathered in the name of Jesus, you're there in the midst. We thank you, Father God, that we qualify for your presence, Father God, as we're online praying, Father God, as we're online standing in the gap for, Father God, our families, the nation, and we say, Father God, have your way in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, that your word runneth swiftly. We thank you, Father God, that you watch over your word to perform it. We thank you, Father God, that we can send your word and heal, Father God. You said you sent your word and that we're healed and delivered from destruction. We stand in the gap right now, Father God, for those that are getting ready to go into surgery, Father God, sometime here, even this week. We pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that your hands would be upon the surgeons, Father God. We pray, Father God, that your hand would be upon, Father God, the technicians and the nurses and the nurse practitioners. We pray, Father God, that as people go, Father God, for surgery, it's not the doctor or the surgeon, but it's you, the chief surgeon. It's you, Father God, who said that Jesus was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. We thank you, Father God, that healing is of the Lord. We thank you, Father God, that you'll be with people, Father God, that are going in for any type of procedures. We bind up infection. We bind up complication. And we loose the power of the Holy Spirit. We loose the blood of Jesus to have lordship, Father God, right now in those situations. And we thank you, Father God. We bless you. Hallelujah. For your presence, Lord, even in the operating room. We give you lordship, Father God. We thank you, dear Heavenly Father. We thank you. We bless you. We honor you. And we give your name glory and praise and thanksgiving. Jesus, there's none like you. There's none like you in all the earth. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the same, your name alone, Yeshua, your name alone, Jesus, your name alone, Master, your name alone, Savior, your name alone, Emmanuel, your name alone, Jesus, is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. If we had 10,000 tongues, we couldn't praise you enough. But Lord, we bless you, Father God, for the power of the Lord this day. We thank you for your prayer. We thank you that we call unto you, Lord, and you said that you would answer and show us great and mighty things that we know not. We thank you, Father God, for the power of the Holy Spirit moving upon the nation, Father God. We pray, Father God, for those that are in authority, that we might lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness. We pray, Father God, for the president of these United States. We pray for his cabinet, Father God. We lift up members, dear Heavenly Father, of all parties, dear Heavenly Father, independent, Republican, Democratic. We lift them all up to you, Father God, because the government is upon your shoulders and your will be done on earth, Father God, as it already is in heaven. We pray, Father God, that you continue to move godly people into places of authority, because when godly people are in authority, Father God, the city can rejoice. We thank you, Father God, for leading and guiding them in the very decisions that they'll make that will affect our life, Father God. Give them clarity of mind. Give them clarity of purpose. We thank you, Heavenly Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, we bless you, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for hearing our prayer, Father God. We thank you for your eye being on the righteous and your ear open unto our prayer. Father God, we pray for our online community. You know, Father God, the needs of each and every person. But Lord, you said, my God shall supply all their needs according to your riches and glory through Christ Jesus. Father God, we thank you for healing, Father God. We thank you for comfort, Father God, right now. For those that are getting ready, Father God, for a homegoing service for their loved ones, we pray for your Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, that the power of the Holy Spirit, Father God, would be and surround families right now, dear Heavenly Father, that are planning, Father God, homegoings. They've lost, Father God, loved ones. We thank you, Father God, for comforting their hearts in the name of Jesus. We say, peace be still, Father God, to their minds, if they're concerned, Father God. If there's worries, Father God, we pray that they're able to cast their cares on you because you careth for us in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you right now. We pray that family members would be on one accord. We come against discord, Father God, in the name of Jesus, dissension. We bind the works of the enemy, Satan, Father God, that families would be on one accord concerning final arrangements for their loved one. In the name of Jesus Christ, we say, peace be still. We thank you for lifting up a standard, dear Heavenly Father, that they will work together. They'll communicate with one another. They'll walk in love and in unity in the name of Jesus. Right now, Father God, we say peace and unity in those families and unity amongst those siblings. Peace and unity. We decree it. Peace and unity. Peace and unity. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, there's none like you. None like you in all the earth. And we thank you, Father God, this day for what you're doing. We bless you.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Father, we bless you this morning just for the opportunity to be able to come before you, Lord, and just to seek you, God. What a privilege, what an honor it is, God, to seek your face, Jesus. Lord, to know that you are here this morning, God. You are in our very homes, God. Lord, that your presence fills wherever we are, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, that your presence fills wherever we are, Lord. Thank you, God, that you are so valuable, God, so valuable, God, that we are able to seek you, Lord, God, with all of our hearts. Thank you for giving us a mind, Lord, to seek your face, Lord. Thank you for giving us a heart to seek your face, Jesus. We bless you today. We bless you. We bless you. We bless you. We begin to even think on the goodness of who you are, God. We begin to admire, Lord, your wonderful characteristics, Lord. God, you're so mighty, Lord. You're so mighty. You can do anything, God. There's nothing too difficult. There's nothing too hard, Lord. God, that you cannot accomplish, Lord. You're a strong God who's able to save and deliver us. You're able to save and deliver us not only from our troubles, oh God, but even from the people that trouble us, oh God. Thank you for your mighty hand of deliverance, Lord. That hand that saves us, that hand that reaches out to us, that hand that is unashamed to associate with sinful people and take a hold of our lives and transform the very person that we are. Thank you, Jesus, for your hand of healing, oh God. Thank you that you're the mighty healer, Jesus, that there is no sickness, there is no disease that can cause you to stumble, Jesus, but you are the mighty healer, Lord. And we bless you for that. God, you're a wonderful Lord. Lord, you're able to govern, Lord, every single situation, God. You take every moment, Lord, every thought, Lord, every word, every action, God, every inaction, God. You have taken it into account, Lord, and you have worked all things, Lord, for your glory and for our good, Lord. You've worked all things, Lord, for your glory and for our good. We praise you, God, for the ability to do that. Who is like our God? Who is like our God? There is no one like you, Jesus. And we just count it an honor and a privilege, God, to just think on you, oh God. Thank you, God, that we can fill our minds, Jesus, with the word of God. Lord, that when situations don't look like they're very favorable, Lord, thank you that your word sets a standard in our mind, oh God, that even when our feelings and our emotions, God, are driving us to the left and to the right as if we were in an ocean, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, that your word, Jesus, is the anchor to our soul, God, that no matter what anything looks like, Jesus, that what you have said, Lord, what you have said, what you have spoken gives us a hope, God. We thank you for that great hope. We thank you, God, that we are not hopeless people, but each day, God, we can rise and know, Lord, that you are working today, Jesus. Thank you. We can rise and know that you have good plans for us today, Jesus. We can rise and know that no matter the turmoil, God, even in the society, Lord, even in the nations, Jesus, God, even with the leaders, God, in the different parts of the world, we know, Jesus, that you have everything, God, under your control. And we bless you, Lord, for your great wisdom, Lord. We bless you for the wisdom, God, and even withholding certain things that we've prayed about, Lord, that you even didn't give them to us, God, knowing, God, that we were not ready, Jesus. We thank you for the wisdom of knowing how to keep us from places that we were not ready to be at, God. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. God, for even the desires, Lord, that we've had in our heart, God, that have not been from you, God, that you have withheld from us, oh God, when we did not know, God, what we were going to, when we did not know the road, God, we were traveling to. Thank you, Jesus, that you have kept us safe, Lord. You have kept us safe, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that you have kept us safe, Jesus. Thank you that you are that one, that great protector, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that no matter where we live, oh God, the safest place we can be, Lord Jesus, is in your will. No matter what it looks like around us, God, the safest place that we can be, Lord, is in your will, God. Thank you that when the enemy rises up against us, God, that you are our great defender, Lord. You are our great deliverer, Jesus. Jesus. We thank you, Jesus, for being our defender. We thank you for the ability for you to fight for us, God, that you can fight for us, Jesus, that the enemies that we could not conquer, Jesus, thank you that there are certain things, Lord, that only you can conquer, Jesus, that only you can get the praise for, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. We glorify your name, Lord. We're so excited to even just be able to even bless you, oh God, and share you with others, oh God. Thank you, Lord, for the spirit of evangelism, God, rising up in your church, Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus that you would raise up your sons and your daughters to go and share your good news, God. Lord, I pray that they would do it not just haphazardly, oh God, but may we have a wisdom in our souls. May we have a wisdom, Lord, in our tongue, oh God. May we have the spirit of boldness, oh God, to be unashamed of your word, of the things that you have established before the foundation of the world. And I pray, Jesus, that out of the overflow of our hearts, God, out of the overflow of what we've done at home and seeking you in your word, Jesus, of seeking you, God, with our faces, Lord, to the ground in prayer, God, of seeking you in fasting, oh God, of seeking you in consecration. I pray, God, that as we go out to the world, Lord, that they would feel a difference, Jesus, that they would feel a difference in how we talk, that they would feel a difference even in our presence, oh God, that they would feel a difference, God, in the way that we are able to even interact with different people. And I pray, Lord Jesus, that you would cause a fire, Lord, to even fill us, Lord, a fire even in our hands, oh God, to go and lay hands on the sick, Lord, that they may recover, Jesus. Lord, that you would give us, Lord, the authority, God, which we already have, Lord, to cast out demons, Lord, and to set loose, God, to free in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus for those things that cannot be argued against, Lord. I pray for those things that cannot be thought against, oh God. And God, I pray for those demons, God. I pray, God, that those things will be broken in the name of Jesus, Lord. May you give us the wisdom, oh God, to know when it's time to pray, when it's time to call on your authority, Jesus, when it's time to release, God, your power, God. Oh God, may we stop arguing, God, and may we start praying, Jesus. May we stop arguing, Jesus, and may we start praying, Jesus. Oh God, I pray that even the humble ones, oh God, the ones who don't even know what to say, Jesus, God, that you would show yourself strong, Jesus. May you show yourself strong in them, oh God. Those who have not even been able to have certain positions, Jesus, Lord, I pray that you would take the common person, that humble Christian, oh God, that son, that daughter, Lord, and that you would use them for your mighty works. Jesus, I pray that you would raise up your people, oh God. Raise up your people, oh God. Oh God, we have been asleep, Jesus. We have been asleep, Jesus. Raise us up. Open up our eyes, Jesus. Open up our eyes that we may be ready, Jesus. That way we may be ready for your return, Jesus. May we be vigilant, oh God. May we be as watchmen, Jesus. May we be the ones that look, that we do not miss your voice, Jesus. That we do not miss your word, Jesus. Oh God, that you would give us a spirit of father, God, the spirit of a father, Lord Jesus. That we would be mature, Jesus. Raise up, not just a carnal church, Jesus, but raise up a mature church, Jesus. We ask, God, that you would forgive us, Lord, for our attitudes, Jesus, even as the church, God, has taken on the attitude of the world, Jesus. We pray that you would forgive us, Lord, for seeking after our own interests first, God, before we look out for the interests of others, Jesus. We ask that you forgive us, Jesus, of not being Christ-like in our character, Lord, knowing, Jesus, that you are the one that gave the greatest sacrifice, Jesus, and you told us that we have a cross to bear, Jesus. I pray that you would forgive us, God, God, of worldly attitudes, oh God, where we put other people down with our words, God, where we use words towards other people that we would not like to receive ourselves, Jesus. We pray that you would forgive us, oh God, for being greedy, Father, for being self-centered, God, even with our finances, oh God. God, where we made sacrifices for ourselves, but we didn't make sacrifices for those who needed it, Jesus. We pray that you would forgive us,
us, oh God, even for forgetting, God, to be generous, God, towards the church, Jesus, when we took care of our own house, God, where you bless your people, Jesus, when they looked after your house. We pray that you would forgive us, oh God, forgive us of attitudes, God, that we've had, God, that are wrong, Jesus. Forgive us, oh God, of hiding even sin in our own homes, Jesus. God, where you, God, where we tried to look good in front of other people, Jesus, but we were not righteous in our home, Jesus. I pray that you would forgive us, Lord, for the way that we've treated our husbands, oh God. Forgive us for the way that we treated our wives, oh God. Forgive us, God, for the way we've mistreated our children, oh God. Forgive us, oh God, how we cheated on our taxes, God. Forgive us, oh God, how we stole from different places, Jesus, thinking it was just okay, thinking that there was nothing wrong with this, God, when something in our soul told us that this was not right. Jesus, forgive us, oh God. I pray that you would forgive us, oh God, of sexual immorality, God, where we've taken the attitude of the world and thought that it was just okay, that we could just get over it, Jesus, and we did not take it seriously, Jesus. Forgive us, oh God, of lustful thoughts, oh God, that we've entertained, God, that we've not been vigilant, God, with the things that we look at, God. Forgive us, God, for hearing lustful things, God, and not being vigilant, God, with what we hear. For you said that if our eye causes us to sin, to pluck it out, Jesus. If our hand causes us to sin, God, to cut it off, Jesus. And we've not had that mentality, Jesus. Lord, we have just been casual about sin, Jesus. We've just been casual, Jesus, about the things that hurt you. And Lord, we pray that you would forgive us, God, that we are not hurt when you are hurt, God, that we are not joyful when you are joyful, Lord, that we are not carrying the attitude that you have, Jesus. Forgive us, Jesus, for not doing our best on our jobs, oh God. Forgive us, God, for waiting for the managers to leave, Jesus, for us to do whatever we want to do, oh God, for wasting other people's times, Jesus. Forgive us, oh God, even for the attitude of not caring about the lost, Jesus. Forgive us that we no longer care about our neighbor, Lord, that we haven't even told anybody about you in a long time, Jesus. Forgive us, Jesus. Forgive us, God, for doing things that didn't please you, Jesus. Lord, we pray that you would forgive us, God, for our lack of effort, God, of even spending time in prayer, Jesus. God, that we spent time in watching television, God, that we made room for telephone calls, God, that we made room to go to the spa, Jesus, that we made room to go to the gym, Jesus, but we didn't make room and we didn't have priority to have you be first, Jesus. Forgive us, Lord, for not even spending time in your word, Jesus, and thinking that we could get our word from Instagram and YouTube, God, and these small little things that were just supplements, Jesus. God, when you've called us to be in your word, Jesus, when you've called us to be in your temple, Jesus, when you've showed us the example of even as you were young, Jesus, that you were in the house of God asking questions, learning, Jesus, forgive us for not valuing your word, Jesus. Forgive us for not valuing what you say, Jesus. Forgive us for even spending a time in your word, God, and not even doing what you told us to do, God. Forgive us, Lord, for the sin of omission, God, the sin of omission, oh God, the sin of omission, Lord, where you told us to do something, Jesus, and we did not do it, God, where we were slow, God. God, forgive us, God, for not living according to faith, Jesus, but living according to the spirit of fear, God, where we were fearful to fail, Jesus, fearful to trust in you, knowing that you would, God, knowing that you would come through for us, God. Forgive us, God, forgive us, forgive us, forgive us, and God, we ask that you would cleanse our hearts, Jesus, cleanse our hearts, oh God, cleanse those areas, God, those secret areas of our lives, Jesus. Cleanse us, God, of unforgiveness, God. Cleanse us of division, oh God. God, cleanse us of offenses, oh God. Cleanse us of those things, God, where we started to hate our brother and our sister, oh God. Cleanse us, oh God, when we have held things for a long time, and we pray, Jesus, that the blood of Jesus would free us, Jesus, that the blood of Jesus would free everything that we have been bound to in the name of Jesus. God, you told us that we are not slaves to sin, Jesus. We're not slaves to sin. We are free in you. We are no longer slaves to sin, that we should obey its lust. So we pray for freedom in the name of Jesus. We pray for freedom in our own hearts, Jesus. We pray for freedom from spirits, oh God, that we've been dealing with, oh God, mental battles that we've been dealing with, Jesus. We pray for the spirit of freedom in the name of Jesus. God, I pray for fresh testimonies today, God. I pray for those people who've been dealing with something for a a long time, Jesus, that have thought that this would never change. I pray in the name of Jesus that we would remember that all things are possible when we believe. I pray that we would remember your word, that you have freed us, Lord, from the spirit of sin. Oh God, you freed us from those things. We no longer have to be bound to them. And I pray, Lord, that there will be new testimonies, God, that that person that has not let go of something in a long time, that they would let it go. I pray in the name of Jesus that even people who've been dealing with sicknesses, God, and diseases for a long time, where they felt like this was going to be a way of life, Jesus, I pray that you, God, would free that person, that you would bring healing to that person, even as you brought healing to the woman with the issue of blood, God, that as we would come to you desperately, Jesus, God, that as we would come to you, God, even with the spirit of a child, God, believing, God, that you can still do it, Jesus, believing, Jesus, that even in our old age, you can still do it. Is anything too hard for our Lord? Is anything too hard for Jesus? God, I bless you, God, for the new things that you're doing in this earth, oh God. I thank you that you're bringing your church back to you, God. I thank you that you are bringing maturity back to your church, God. I thank you, God, that no longer would we have an appetite for shallow words, God, that don't convict us, Jesus, but God, that we would have an appetite to be corrected, God, that we would have an appetite to be rebuked, Jesus, for you said in your word, Jesus, that you correct those whom you love, God, and we believe and trust that you are causing us to walk in your ways. May we look more like you each and every day, God, less like us and more like you, God. Let us put our will to the back burner, Lord, and let us look unto you. Let us look unto you, the value of doing your will, Jesus. I pray, God, for freedom, God, even those who've been confused in the name of Jesus. God, I pray that you would, God, open up their eyes, God. God, they've been walking in a forest, God, and they haven't known where to go. Should they go to the left and to the right? They haven't known, God, but I pray that there will be a clarity, Lord, a clarity of seeing you. May you even just show up, Jesus, show up in their bedroom. God, show up in their dreams, oh God. Show up even in their conversations. I pray that you would even use the mouth of others to confirm your word in their life, oh God. And I pray, Lord, that they would have the boldness to walk forth, oh God, that no longer would the spirit of confusion, oh God, of not knowing what relationship to be in, I pray that you would bring clarity, Jesus, clarity, Jesus. Bring boldness in the name of Jesus to cut off relationships, God, that are ungodly, Lord, that have caused us to sin in the name of Jesus. Jesus, you said that that bad company corrupts good morals. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would give us the boldness to cut those relationships off that we should not be in the name of Jesus. We pray that we would not follow our feeling, but we would follow faith, that we would not follow what we want, but we would follow what you want, Jesus. I pray that as we even remove, God, remove those things by our will and our decision, God, not by the way that we feel, not that by the way that they make us feel, Lord, that as we decide, Jesus, as we decide who is in our inner circle, Jesus, that you would begin to fill it, God, with godly people, that you would begin to fill it with people that lift us to another level, oh God. I pray, oh God, that no longer would we be afraid to have relationships that make us uncomfortable, that share with us the things that we need to improve upon, God. But Jesus, we are open. We are open even to being rebuked, Jesus. We are open to being told about the things that we need to grow in, Jesus. May you grow your church. May you grow your church. Grow your church, oh God. Grow it in you, Jesus. Grow it in you, Jesus. Grow it in you, God. And may there be a spirit of unity, Jesus. A spirit of unity, oh God. May we no longer cause politics to divide us, oh God. May we no longer cause skin color to divide us, oh God. May we no longer cause offenses to divide us, Jesus. But you said that by this would men know that you are my disciples, that we love one another, Jesus. You didn't say, God, that it would be a perfect relationship. You didn't say that they wouldn't offend us, Jesus. You didn't say that they wouldn't hurt us, Jesus. But you said to love even our enemies, Jesus. And I pray for a spirit of unity in your church, Lord. I pray for a spirit of unity in your church, God, that we may walk in a spirit of unity, Lord, that no longer would we be divided, Lord, but that we would walk in a spirit of unity, Jesus, walking as one man, walking as one man, walking as one man, Lord, towards a known destination, Jesus. May we walk according to your ways, Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus that you would command our steps, God, that you would order our steps, oh God, that you would speak to our steps, oh God. Order our steps in the Lord. Order our steps in the Lord. Order those steps that have not been moving in the name of Jesus. Order those steps that have been almost as concrete and stone where they've just been sitting there. I pray that you would begin to break those things off, oh God, and begin to cause your people to move forward in you, 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 Jesus, by the spirit of boldness, oh God, that we would go and change the world, oh God, that we would go and speak to our neighbor, oh God, that we would go and speak to those at the grocery store. I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that you would give us a word, 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 God, and don't just do it just easily, God, but I pray, oh God, that we would show the discipline, God, of being in your word, of being in your word, Jesus, where we spent time in your word, and that there will be a deposit, Jesus, a rich deposit in our heart, not about our own opinion, Jesus, but about what you have said. May your word live richly in our hearts. May your word live richly in our hearts. May your word, Jesus, live richly in our hearts, oh God, that we may hide your word in our heart and not sin against you, Jesus. No longer tossed to and fro by this wave and that wave of doctrine. No longer tossed to and fro by what this person says and what that person says. No longer tossed to and fro, God, about the philosophies of the world that sound good, oh God, that please our own desires, oh God. But I pray, Jesus, that we would look unto you, Jesus, look unto you, for in your presence, there is fullness of joy. In your presence, Jesus, there is healing. In your presence, there is deliverance, Jesus. I pray that your people would see as they draw closer to you, God, as they draw closer to your presence, Jesus, that things would just fall off, Jesus. I pray for a spirit of peace. A spirit of peace, a spirit of peace. I pray, God, that those things that your people have been worried and concerned about, God, just worried and concerned about, Lord, I pray for a spirit of peace, Jesus. Give us eyes to see what you see. Give us eyes to see what you see. Jesus, I pray that you would take us alone, Jesus. Take us alone, God. Set us apart for a few moments, God. Take us to the mountain with you and show us, Jesus. Show us, Jesus, your perspective. Help us to see what you see. Help us to see the hurt that caused the hurt. God, help us to see the pain that caused the pain, Jesus. Help us to see those things, Jesus, that you see, that we may pray more effectively, Jesus. Lord, that we would not pray according to what we see in the flesh, Lord, but we would pray according to what we see in the spirit. Would you open up our eyes, Jesus? Would you open up our eyes, Lord? Would you open up our eyes? We are asking you, Jesus, to open up the eyes, God. Open up the eyes, Jesus. Open up our eyes, Jesus. Open up those blinded eyes, Jesus. I pray that you would open up our eyes, God, to see what you see, oh God. God, open up our eyes, oh God, even as your minister saw it, God, even as he was being stoned, God, let us see your glory, Jesus. Show us your glory, Jesus. God, I pray, God, that we would have the hunger, God. God, that we would value you so much, oh God, that we would put away our own desires, God, and you would show us your glory, oh God. Show us those hidden places, God, that you have for us. Show us those hidden treasures, God, that you have for us. God, show us, God, that we may walk in purpose, oh God. Lord, I pray that each day, God, would not be a wasted day, God, but that we would realize that this is the day that you have made. Today is the day that you had made, and therefore there is purpose. Therefore there is liberty. Therefore there is change. Therefore there is progress. Therefore there is truth, oh God. Let us see this day as valuable, oh God. Let us no longer waste our days, God, doing nothing, oh God. But oh God, I pray that you would place a fire in our feet, oh God, to move, oh God. I pray that you would place a fire in our feet to move towards your destiny, oh God, to move towards your purposes, oh God, to move towards the things that you've called us to do, oh God. Place a fire in this, in the feet of your people, oh Jesus. And I pray, God, that we would have such fire in our feet, God, that when we look back, that we realize that we've set the world on fire, Jesus. Lord, I pray that you would raise up, God, even those believers, God, across the nations, oh God. God, those bold believers, oh God. God, may we draw boldness from their boldness, oh God. May you raise up people in Asia, oh God, young leaders, oh God, who would bring your word, God, to that part of the world, Jesus. We lift them up even now, Jesus. We pray that you would provide every single need that they have, Jesus. Anything that they think that they lack, oh God, I pray that even as Jesus, Lord, as you even sent your servant forward to go and get the donkey, Jesus, that God, we would just be able to send your word, send somebody and say, the Lord has need of this. And I pray, God, that those provisions will be brought back in the name of Jesus. Thank you, oh God, for raising up leaders, God, even in the Middle East, oh God. God, even leaders that are wise and bold, wise and bold, wise and bold, wise and bold, oh God. I pray, God, that you would break down those plans of the enemy. Break down those plans of the enemy. We call them failed. We call them failures, Jesus. We pray, God, that your plan would go forth, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that when the enemy thought he was winning, Jesus, thank you, Jesus, that you are the one that turns it around, Jesus. Thank you that you're the one that turns it around, God. I pray, God, that even as they go forth, oh God, even as those enemies go forth, God, when they would turn around, that they would see that you are behind them, oh God, and that you would, God, almost just collapse on them, Jesus, and God, bring victory to your people, bring victory to your people, oh God. God, those things, God, that have been trying to settle, God, God, in the Middle East, oh God, I pray that you would loosen those things, God, and remove them, Lord, and may your word remain true. May your word go forth. Lord, is anything too hard for you? Is any situation too hard for you, Lord? We pray, God, that you would turn around the hearts of your people, cause your people to know you once again. Cause your people to know you once again, Jesus. Cause your people to know you once again, God, that they would be so close to you. Oh, God, bring us closer to you. God, bring us closer to you. Closer, closer. God, I pray that you would bring us closer, not tomorrow, Jesus, but today, God, that as we drive in our cars, that we would have a song in our heart, oh God. Lord, that as we're at work, Jesus, that we would have you on our minds, Jesus. Lord, that we would be once again in love with you, Lord. God, even as we were in love with you before, God, where we couldn't stop thinking about you, where we couldn't stop talking about you, where we couldn't stop just doing things, God, that pertain to you, Jesus. Bring us back to a first love, oh God. And God, may it not be an immature love, God, that kind of just goes back and forth, God. But I pray for a mature love, oh God. I pray for that kind of love of a 50 year anniversary kind of love, Jesus, where we walk with you, Lord, where our love is not based on a feeling, but it's based on a truth, Jesus. I pray that there will be an anchor, God, in our soul, God. Lord, I pray that those around us would recognize it, that as things are feeling just chaotic around us, God, that they would see us, God, and know there's something different, God. And may you open up the door to the gospel, Jesus. May you open up the door to the gospel, Lord. May you open up that door to the gospel of Jesus Christ, Jesus. And I pray that we would be so seasoned in your word that no, we would not just let them know about you, Lord, but God, as you said, that we would teach them, Lord, teach them to obey everything that you have commanded us, Lord, that through the character of God, I pray that the character of Jesus Christ would be developed in your people. The character of Jesus Christ would be developed in your people, Lord, that we would look like you, that we would make decisions, God, that glorify you, that we would speak, God, in such a way that reflects who you are. Take away, Lord, the filthy tongue. Take away, Lord, that filth, God, from our mouth, oh God. Take away the complaining, God. Take away the backbiting, God. Take away the slander, oh God. Take away the gossiping, God. Take away the putting down of others, Jesus. And God, I pray that your people would build with their words, that they will build their neighbor. Encourage them, Jesus. I pray that you would cause us to build with our words. Build, build, not tear down, but build, oh God. May you use our tongue as yours, Jesus. We give you our tongue today, Jesus. God, we set it on the altar and we ask, Lord, that no longer our own words would come out of those, out of that tongue, Lord, but your words, God, your words, God, your beautiful word infused with our personality and the gifts that we already have. May it just flow out of us. May people hear your voice today, God, because we took the time to speak your word. May people hear your voice today, God, because we took the time to speak your word. Now, God, we ask, God, that you would bless us, God. Oh, God, we're blessed to bless you, God, but we ask that you would bless us, Lord. Bless us with more of you. We don't ask for things today, God. We ask for you, God. We ask for time with you. We ask for hearing your voice, oh God. We ask that you would speak to us, God. We ask that we would be in your presence, God. God, we don't have to walk away from your presence, Jesus. You can walk right on the inside of us, Lord. We ask that you would fill us, oh God. May things go smoother because we spent time with you. May things happening in our favor, Lord, because we spent time with you, Jesus. May we be quicker to even accomplish certain things, Lord, because we spent time with you, Lord. May we be able to figure certain things out in a much faster way because we spent time with you, Jesus. And may you bless us, Lord. May you cause us to be a blessing, Jesus. Don't just bless us for us, Jesus, but we look to be a blessing today. We look to be a blessing today, and we honor and we praise you for the opportunity to be a blessing. We're open vessels to you, Jesus. We're open. Pour through us, Jesus. Pour through us, God. And God, as we pour out to others, may you pour into us, God. God, we know that as we go, as we serve others, Lord, we know that you'll take care of us, oh God. As we bless other children, God, we know that you'll take care of our children, oh God. As we treat other people right, we know that you'll take care about our concerns, Jesus. As we're continuing to be generous, oh God, we know that you'll take care of our finances. We don't have to worry, Jesus, that you won't take care of us, God, because we know that you're our great provider. And we bless you for that, God. What an honor and a privilege to be in your presence. God, we just place a bookmark, Lord, a bookmark, as it were, Lord, in this moment, God. And we can't wait, Jesus, to come back to the next page, Jesus. We cannot wait to come back to the next page, Jesus, because we know that there is better. We know that there is better. We know that there is more, Jesus. We know, God, and we are excited for what you have that will unfold in our lives, oh God. We are expecting, oh God, we can't wait to the next episode, Jesus, because where there was lack, oh God, there will be provision, oh God. Where there was failure and defeat, there will be victory in the name of Jesus. And we place a bookmark, Lord, knowing, God, that there is yet another page. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen.
Oh, we give you glory, Lord. We give you glory and we give you honor. And we thank you, Father God, that the effectual, fervent prayers of the righteous, they availeth much. Word of Faith Online Church, thank you so much for joining. As we mentioned in the beginning, our theme is Seeking the Face of God, coming from 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. For our first day of intercession today, we focused on returning to God through repentance, asking forgiveness. We pray that you'll be able to join us tomorrow at 5 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And tomorrow, we're going to be making intercession for the elderly, the children, and our families. We won't have a benediction until the fifth day of our corporate prayer. May the Spirit of the Lord rest upon you and bless you. We thank you for joining and look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning. In Jesus' name, amen.